What is this big thing?
The only time I ever see us use these is in like in Home Depot.
The only Swedish snacks I've had are from Christmas stands and then IKEA.
The only thing that I know about Sweden is like Swedish fish. I know that's very basic.
I'm a dual citizen of Sweden and America, and I have family in Sweden, and I've been going back and forth to visit them most of my life growing up.
I've been here for 5 years. My roommate in college had a lot of candy that he like brought home. But I never wanted to try it, so I'm like, I'm still pretty fresh with it.
I'm imagining regular traditional cookie with some chocolate. Nothing too spicy from these Swedish people in those respects.
We're pretty into sweet stuff. Swede stuff.
Whoa!
Polly's famous in Sweden because it was like one of the first candies I can remember that had a really good jingle. Like, everyone's different in the world, everyone have their own thing, but at least had Polly in common.
It's chocolate, butter, toffee, and vanilla. It smells really good, and I kind of want one.
This is a Reese's peanut butter cup. Chocolate on the outside, peanut butter on the inside, made into a special little cup for you to bite into. Enjoy.
It's pretty sugary, but it tastes really good. It's like what I would want peanut butter to taste like.
It's a bit too sweet.
I think only peanut butter lovers in Sweden would really like this, but I think we'll stick to our chocolate.
Okay, so I'm gonna try Polly. Mm-hmm. Is there alcohol in this?
Look like a mixture of Dots and Milk Duds, which who doesn't love both of those classics? I mean, yeah, it's very good.
It's really good, yeah.
I mean, I like it.
It just feels like the chocolate in European chocolate versus American chocolate is, it just definitely does not feel as, you know, sugary and processed.
Yeah.
Of this two, look at Polly.
I'd eat it if it was around the office, but I would definitely go for these first.
To give some backstory, we actually have this thing in Sweden called Fridagsmys, like a cozy Friday. And so we go to the store and we pick up all these Swedish godis, which is Swedish candy. Chocolate is really, really popular over there. And if it's not good, we're not gonna have it.
They're very good. I can see any American taking down a whole bag of these, no issue. So both winners in my book.
In the US, you have a water cooler moment. We have like a fika, so like after lunch, you go for coffee. Like we barely work in Sweden, we just have coffee all the time.
Oh, God.
And then usually this is for the fika.
Well, this is a Rice Krispie treat. They just took the cereal Rice Krispies and they made it into a treat by adding marshmallows to it. They have these so that when your mom leaves you a little lunch, she can write, I love you on it, and then just give it to you. So here you go.
Huh?
Yes.
It's pretty good.
Oh.
There's one that's gonna stay on the top.
Okay.
And then one's gonna stay in the bottom. Oh, good. It feels very sweet. I'm not sure.
Finish it off for you. But I do like this. I found myself reaching to eat another one.
Good in the mix. Probably one of the big staples of Swedish candy.
What we like the most is the bitter, salty black licorice right here. But it comes with the fruity ones too, if you have a sweeter palate.
The gummies are great because you have such an opportunity to put like salt on them if you want to. So like,
do you think a lot of Swedish snacks are aimed at adults and children, but they're trying to elevate a child's palate on their way of doing it?
I don't know if they have any real purpose for it. I think they just enjoy sweets to survive the winter.
Yeah, these are just a movie theater snack. You just kind of like, shove them all in.
Why is it called Nerds?
I think these little things, they're like little creatures called Nerds, and you're eating them.
I hated black licorice. I hated it. And then as I've gotten older, you know, you just kind of mature or whatever.
Well, I have to agree with you too, because when I was a kid, I didn't like black licorice either.
Mm.
But now I kind of have more of a palate for it.
My favorite one is the sweet licorice one, which is
God,
that one.
I hate licorice.
I think you should just try it. Gross. Do I want to apologize before or after this question?
I don't know.
This is really good.
Expanding your horizons.
I know, I've grown up.
Licorice.
I mean, it's licorice. Don't. It's not the worst licorice.
I've
had worse. No, it's getting worse. The rest of these taste like great gummies, but I just don't know why would you want all of them in the same bag. All right, try it. Hold out your hand.
Okay. Whoa.
They're very bright colors. They're so tiny. That's really sweet.
Wow, it's so much flavor. Oh my God.
It's so good, right?
Yeah, it really is actually. Better than that.
Oh my God, thank you. Cause I just took a bite of something and I don't know what it was. It was a blackfish.
That's the, no.
I had
don't do that one.
So you're a fan of the Nerds?
I'm a nerd.
This is more nostalgic for me. I would kind of be more favorable to this. But I think this is kind of cool and new because we don't really have something like this in Sweden.
Licorice as a candy genre in general, I love going with these guys.
Bilar. Okay, so this just means cars, but this is like a really well-known candy throughout Sweden. You can actually find it in almost every IKEA store too.
They're not super sugary, but they're very flavorful, I would say.
So they're kind of like gummy marshmallows, if that makes sense.
Feels too dry at first.
Mm-hmm. So much of candy makes sense to me now.
Can I show you something to do? Take out two of them. You want it to be like stuck to each other almost. Oh, can I have one? I really want to have one.
He's dying.
I actually really like it.
I'm happy because that's really like my childhood.
This is very good, and the flavor is almost identical to that, quite honestly.
Really? Yeah, the texture is like way off. I'm gonna compare. Hold on. No way, this is like gummy marshmallow, and this is just a gummy.
Let's see.
And the flavor is subtle. It's like having LaCroix water or something.
So the biggest difference between these and the Swedish ones, so they're not solid enough. I like them, I do like the Swedish version better. They're a little bit too sweet for me. I'm apologizing ahead of time already. I don't have this because I think it's weird.
I've never actually had this before. It's shrimp cheese. I'm not sure how you're gonna take to the fish flavor because it surprises a lot of people.
Yeah, like my throat is already like protecting itself.
I would say probably had this for afternoons when you get home from school. All the friends that I had to like that did that.
Now, this is my weakness. As an American who grew up well-versed in the snack world game, I am addicted to artificial prepackaged cheese. Whatever food scientists made that up,
I'm not really like a big canned cheese girl. I know that it's a thing to take these and put it on crackers. And if you're even more of a weird person, it's a thing to just go like, I know that they said it's made with real cheese. Don't believe it.
First of all, we should just never eat anything that comes out of like
a can,
a can that will explode if you put it next to fire.
Whoa.
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 It's just like kind of like shits on your cracker.
Wow. Why?
What do you mean why?
It's like too cheesy almost.
I'll believe it just a little amount.
Oh, it's like a little smiley face. That's how happy you are with this. I get why you like this so much.
Chemical cheese, give it to me. This is like paint.
Don't put too much on. I'm really serious here.
Tell me when to stop.
Yeah, just try that.
Oh my God, I'm probably so scared.
Yeah, I'm so sorry.
All right, shrimp cheese, let's go.
I'm on board with this as well.
Yeah?
Yeah.
So we both love chemical cheese.
Oh, hell
no matter
yeah.
The country.
Because I know how shitty that is. I'm gonna pick this.
To be honest, I would take this. This is way subtle.
It wasn't like overpowering anything. More of like an aftertaste, you can start to taste the shrimp.
But it's really light. It's like hardly a flavor to it.
Given 20 seconds, you'll start to, you can taste the
shrimp.
Now
you get it now?
Yeah, which is.
Oh yeah, there it is.
Okay. Yeah.